For more on RFK Jr.'s decision to suspend his presidential campaign, let's bring in David Avella, the GOPAC chairman. So give us your analysis of this decision and what it means. I mean, why does a guy whose name is long associated with the Democratic Party, why does he, sort of jump ship and endorse the former president?
John, RFK Jr.'s campaign was over about 12 days ago when a court in New York said he couldn't be on the ballot because he lacked residency. It underscored how the Democratic elites first set up the rules to make sure no one could get the nomination other than President Biden. And now they are determined to make sure that RFK Jr. couldn't get on enough ballots to be able to get the 270 votes that you have to be president. It's the ultimate sign of weakness. And it could be an underscoring of the fact of how weak Vice President Harris is, and that she may have already peaked in this election. Because keep in mind, you have a state like Wisconsin, where in 2016 and in 2020, it was decided by one percentage point. You take a candidate like RFK, and maybe he doesn't have 1% that goes towards Trump, but maybe Trump picks up another 2,000 votes or 3,000 votes. In an election in Wisconsin that's going to get decided by 25,000 votes, all little things matter. And RFK getting out may seem like a little thing, but it could prove quite decisive in the swing states.
Yeah, he's been criticized even by members of his own family for the decision that he's made. Essentially, I guess you could say he's leaving the Democratic Party. But the Democratic Party that exists today is not the Democrat Party that, you know, elected his father, his uncle, and his father.
Hey, it's somewhat funny, though, John, given that it was RFK Jr.'s dad who ran against and helped push out Lyndon Johnson in 1964. It was his uncle, Teddy Kennedy, who ran against Jimmy Carter and ultimately helped lead to that defeat in 1980. The Democratic Party has always had to deal with a Kennedy who wanted to go against the establishment. RFK Jr. is just the latest. But now we're at a point, John, where it's exactly where Republicans need it to be. Because we get to make the case that do you want the American dream? As Donald Trump talks about free market capitalism, and he talks about bringing regulations down, and he talks about fair trade deals and a secure border, you contrast that with the American nightmare that ultimately Vice President Harris would bring to us. It's that they're going to tell you what car you can drive. They're going to make your taxes go up. They're going to put government in more control of kids' schools than what parents will have. In example after example, look at her policies, and we're heading towards an American nightmare if Vice President Harris ascends to the presidency and continues the Bidenomics and the bad policies that has her and the president at 36% approval rating.
Yeah, we'll get into her econ policies a little bit later on in this hour. But RFK Jr., he has been complaining a lot about the media, and media coverage generally of Kamala Harris has been pretty fawning, wouldn't you say?
She's had a good bump as a result of the coverage that has been given to her, not unlike when many candidates first get into a race. The key, though, is to make sure the media holds her accountable for her policy positions. And we just talked about a few right there where she's got to explain to American people, what exactly does price controls mean? What exactly will she do to help bring inflation down, which is now at 20%? Does she think it's a good idea that the Fed's talking about cutting rates? I mean, going at policy after policy, what is she going to do to make lives Americans safer, easier, and better? And the reality is she doesn't have one that's going to make things better.
The quote from RFK Jr. was, "Who needs a policy," referring to policy speeches that she's outlined, "who needs a policy when you've got Trump to hate?" And that does seem to be a driving force.
That is a core part of their message. But you think about for Americans who are trying to get a better health care, and as the vice president and the president have allowed millions to come in across the border and get immediate access to healthcare systems. It only makes those who are paying the bill for healthcare to have to wait in line longer. It only means they're going to have to pay more in taxes. And to RFK's point, it was his uncle who said that cutting taxes rises all boats, that we have a bigger economy if, in fact, we cut taxes. And as RFK pointed out, the Democratic Party is no longer a party that believes that. In fact, we'll have some Americans paying well over 60% of what they earn to the government if the vice president gets the plan that Joe Biden proposed and she is supporting.
Again, we'll be talking about her economic policies a bit later this hour. David Avella. David, thank you.
Thank you.